that's what sin does to us. It brings misery and depression and all this because we separated from God. And the Lord has the ability to get inside of you and bring restoration and healing. And that's what he did to me. And, you know, there's a scripture in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. It says, anyone who is in Christ, they are new creation. Old things pass away. Behold, all things become new. So when you really surrender your life to the Lord and you acknowledge your sin and you confess Jesus and you ask him, Lord, I want forgiveness. I want to get my life right with you. The presence of God, he makes you new on the inside. He gives you a new heart. And all them old desires, Mark, that I used to have, they all died away. Like the desire to get high, the desire to get drunk, the desire to just live in the world and go party. It's like I was filled with purpose now. I was filled with what I was truly designed to be. And that's a child of God. And I was separated because of sin. And it's like since then, Mark, God has been just bringing me everywhere, connecting me with brothers like him. I met him. This is a brother in Christ that loves the Lord. God changed his life too. And we just been going all over, man, and just telling people about Jesus, preaching the word of God, and just letting them know. Because, Mark, the reality is God has a deep love and wants to save people. But people have to be willing to come to him through Jesus. And if they don't come, Mark, you know, there's a destiny when you die, you know, and we're going to stand before a holy and righteous God, and it's going to be heaven or hell for each and every person. There's a destiny. And, you know, God reaches out to us all the time, bro. You know, I don't know where your heart is with the Lord. I don't know what you think about God, bro, but I know that the Lord puts people in other people's path to just, you know, share a word, something that can plant some direction in a person's life, because God's trying to get people's attention. God's trying to say, look, I want you to come. I want to do something in your life. I want to change you. I can do things. I can bring you alive, because he brought me alive, Mark. I have never been alive like I have been since I gave my life to Jesus. And it's like I was dead before that. Like I was dead. I was miserable. I was depressed. I was oppressed. I felt like I don't know why I was born. I felt like I didn't have no purpose, man. And since the Lord came in my life, I feel his love. He shared his love with me, and he answers my prayers all the time, Mark, all the time, bro. Like, you know, it's not religion. Everybody, there's so many different religions in this world that just, they keep you dead. God is not about a religion. He wants relationship with you. He wants to love you. He wants you to love him. He wants you to know him. But it takes time. It takes a step of faith to say, God, I've been living for myself my whole life. I've been doing my own thing my whole life. And I know that you're real. And I want what you have for me. I don't want to do what I want to do no more. And it takes us to get to that point, you know, to hear the word, to hear the message of the gospel that Jesus Christ, God so loved the world that he sent his son Jesus to die on the cross for us. He died, and on the third day he was resurrected by the power of God so that we can be justified through his grace. But we have to be willing to come to him. And Mark, I testify to you personally. I'm talking about a life transformation the Lord Jesus did in my life, man. And I know that this is what he wants to do for everybody. But God gives each person a choice, you know, like he says in his word. He says, choose this day who you will serve. He says, I set before you blessings or curses, life or death, heaven or hell. You see, so God's saying, look, I want you to come to me, but you got to be willing to come and acknowledge your sin, you know, because we have all sinned against the Lord. None of us are exempt. You know, we all either lied, we all either lusted. You know, different people do different sins. But in the eyes of a holy God and his holy law, we worthy of hell fire because God's law is that holy. So if we just break it one time, we deserving of hell fire. But through Jesus, we can receive forgiveness and a pardon for our sins. But we have to acknowledge him and come to him and be born again by the Spirit of God. And the Lord begins to do some things. He does some rearranging. So he does some renovating on the inside of us. You know, he renovates and gets all that junk on the inside of us out. And he begins to reconstruct construct us into a brand new man. That's the best way I can explain it, Mark. And he's been continually leading me and guiding me since 2010, Mark. Since 2010, I've been living for Jesus Christ. I came from being a known drug dealer in my area that supplied drugs to most of the people in my area, to being changed by the power of God, and God put me back on the streets preaching and telling people about Jesus now. So, you know, that's what he does, bro. He's a life changer. And that's what he wants to do in our lives, you know. Like I said, Mark, I don't know. Maybe this is a divine appointment. Maybe God might be speaking to you right now. I don't know.